Hello there, everyone. It is 1 o'clock Pacific time, and this will be very interesting to see if anyone shows up because I screwed up the boy. Let me tell you, if you end up messing with this automated system in any way, everything goes to hell. So my apologies. Last week, last Friday, I was actually on the radio. I do some radio hosting from time to time, and I was helping out the folks at Roundhouse Radio doing some on air work. And so I changed the time, or I changed the format from live to pre-recorded. Not everyone got it, and then the system sent them a replay of a non-existent one. And then I just realized that I just sent out an email to people saying, "Hey, the This Week in Digital Marketing is on in 15 minutes," and didn't put the link in. So I'm probably getting a whole bunch of people right now emailing. In fact, I just saw one come in saying that they have no idea how to get in. Yep, that's about what I'm seeing. So I'm guessing that you probably are watching on the replay, and thanks very much for that. And we will get started in respect for your time, since I obviously didn't have enough respect for your time in the first place. What a pain. I'm so sorry about that. So anyway, some of you are in here. Three people out of the 354 people that registered. Lori, Emily, and Shefali, thank you. It might just be us. It might just be us in here today, but this will get out to lots of people through the replay. And what a good episode as well. By the way, if you're listening to this on the podcast, or if you are watching on YouTube and you want to get notifications each week that will work in the future, please go to toddmaffin.com/thisweek. I'm going to put up a little poll here while I kind of ramble through this. So if you're listening on the podcast, you won't be able to see this or watching on YouTube later. But if you're watching the replay on the system that it sent you the link, you should be able to see a poll here, just to kind of get a sense of who's there with all of three people watching live. That might be a little difficult. But you just go to toddbaffin.com/thisweek. And my company is called EngageQ. We work with a lot of people. It's very easy. This webinar moves very quickly. It's about a half an hour or so. We talk about the last 7 days of digital and social marketing information. We will have time for questions from both of you. You will get a recording. That's probably how most of you are getting to this, is by watching the recording. Bless your hearts. And of course, you can subscribe to the podcast at any time as well. So five people. All right, we're getting some people there. So if you're just joining us, it's not your fault. My system got messed up last week a little bit by taking a week off to do some other stuff. And it will be back in play soon. And make sure you stick around, because two really cool things in this week's episode. First of all, I'm going to be talking about Tradable Bits. As you know, they're a sponsor of this show. They've got a really cool idea, a system set up called Exclusive Deal, that I'll walk you through. It's a really good way of translating a promotion from the online world to the offline world. So if you sell in a store and you want to know how many people actually redeem an offer, it will be able to tell you. And I prepared a walkthrough of the all-important Facebook pixel. You are going to want to make sure that you stick around for that, because it's the Facebook pixel is so important. It is the most important bit of code that you will never see. And I actually did about an 8-minute video walkthrough that I'll play into the stream for you. Step-by-step, animated, it shows you exactly how to do it. I think it'll be very helpful for you. All right, so there are seven of you in here now because of my inability to do anything right with the system, so I'm going to leave that poll open for just a little bit. All right, on to the news. So yesterday, Facebook introduced this really cool development. They're going to be competing with Periscope and Meerkat. These are those live broadcast systems that you've seen, and they're going to be doing it through live video. Now, people who have verified accounts on Facebook have been able to use live video for a while. I have a verified account. I've tried it. It's all right. You get a special little app called Mentions that is kind of a scaled-down, dumbified version of the app that you have, so you're really not missing anything. But one of the cool things is this ability to go live. So now they're going to be opening it up to everybody. Very cool. Very cool system, and you can see how easy it's going to be. You can say who you want to share it to, so you can share it just to your friends or to everyone, or just family. You know, if you're getting married or someone's getting married and you just want to show it to family, you can do that, and you click go live, and you can see a little chat room underneath as well where you can give people thumbs up. It is going to change the way that the system works, right? It's going to change a little bit. In the Facebook app. So now when you go to compose a message, it's going to look like this. This is kind of how mentions looks, by the way. So you pick what you want to do and move on from there. That is rolling out right now to a small group of Americans who have iPhones. It will be coming to everyone sometime soon. Check your local listings. They also introduced this thing called Collage. I'm actually more excited about this than anything else. It's a really smooth way of posting photographs. Now, before, when you posted photographs into your Facebook stream, it just kind of showed you a chronologically ordered list of all of the images. And if you're a brand and you're doing something like, you know, let's say you have a mall and you're working with, you know, you've got a whole bunch of photos that you want to promote a bunch of stuff in the mall, you just kind of had to pick randomly 1, 2, 3, and it would make a photo album for it. Well, now it'll create these beautiful little collages, and it'll pop up based on where it thinks those events were. And if, Apple's had this for a while in their Photos app, and even before it in iPhoto, called, I think they called it Moments, maybe, where it would say, okay, well, you took like 21 photographs at this location and then nothing for a day, so we think something important happened there. So it groups them all in that area, and that's the way it works as well. So they're rolling this out to iPhone as of yesterday. I don't have it yet. I checked just a little bit. So yeah, very, very peculiar. Very cool. All right, here's what's really neat. Now, you may not have access to this. Somehow I got access to it. As you know, Facebook will let, if you are a brand, you can have people send messages into your Facebook page, right? So you can communicate with them. And it's just kind of been like a very basic chat list. This is what it's going to look like according to tests that I'm actually seeing on one of my pages. Everything looks the same except for, take a look at the right. They're beginning to turn it into a CRM. So one thing that's nice is you can see this away link over here. The reason that is there, excuse me. Oh, man. The reason that is there is that Facebook will put the nice, pretty big blue button on your brand page that says message, send a message, or shop with us, or whatever you've configured that call to action to be. But the pretty blue button, only the nice big one, only shows up if you're engaging with people on a regular basis. You know, for instance, if you are responding, and the threshold is pretty high. It's something like 90% of messages have to be answered within 5 minutes to get that. Like, it's a really high threshold. But what if you go away for office hours, obviously? You know, you're not going to be answering it at 10 o'clock at night. So now you can turn this little away button on, and it will not count against that score. But what I'm interested in is what you're seeing on the right there. And I'm going to scroll down this a little bit. Well, I'm going to show you a slide of what it looks like when you scroll down. Look at what you can begin to add to this thing. So you can start to tag people. These are people who've messaged your page, messaged your brand through your Facebook page with certain things. You can add a keyword. I added a keyword called superfan. You can add your own notes to people that only you or other administrators will see. And you can see a bit of a relationship. Now, the only thing that you can see here so far is page likes, but I expect, you know, as they do more things, if they ask questions of the page, if they participate in promotions that Facebook may be launching, those sorts of things, you may begin to see that here as well. Here's something cool. For the first time that I'm aware, to make it really easy, you can now add attachments. So with this test, by the way, I wasn't that rude to people. I wasn't just say hi, bye. This Sarah Guild is actually a fake account that I control. So I was able to attach the Tradable Books campaign to a message, which is kind of neat. And they got it as an attachment, which is very cool. And by the way, that that Tradable Bits campaign thing, oh, let me stop the poll here. So most of you are selling services to businesses. And some of you are selling products to businesses. So good. Lots of people in businesses. That campaign guide that Tradable Bits has, by the way, I have a link to it. It is a great resource that shows you some examples, some case studies. They actually sent it to me last week. And Emily, I'm sorry. I have not had a chance to look at it in detail to provide feedback. However, really, really, really cool. So, Carrie, thank you. I'm glad that you mentioned that. It's good. It's important to turn that off. You know, that sleeping does count against your score for sure. You can also access your saved replies, and not many people realize you can do this as well. You can create. In fact, let's take a quick check in the chat room right now of those who are watching. Did you know that you can create canned replies for your brand? Are you aware of that? Let me know. It takes about 20 seconds for me to see your responses. It's really cool, actually. It's quite a neat system. You can set it up so that it automatically drops their first name into it or other information. So it's just kind of like a really quick one click there. So some of you know about this. So if you don't know about that, then do try it. So very, very cool. All right, onward. Just a little thing here. Facebook is adding, if you have one of these like boxes on your website, that shows, you know, it's sort of like, hey, like us on Facebook as well. They're boosting that. And the way they're boosting it is they're going to add messaging ability right into it. So people will be able to send a message right from the Facebook message area on this Facebook like box. Now, it's good for Facebook because they get more traffic on their site. Obviously, they get more of the messaging and that brand relationship in the Facebook ecosystem. Might be a little bit confusing for people on your site because you may have this on your website already, a like box, but you probably have a contact us page that you'd prefer people to use for your own reasons. So that's kind of interesting as well. If you have passwords, as you do, for various channels that you might run, and lots of people who have to manage those passwords, you certainly don't want to give those passwords out to everyone. I use a tool called 1Password. It's the number 1 and password. And they've just launched in the last few days a team system. So now you can share passwords to those people who have the rights for them on a password by password basis. So in our case, you know, we work with a couple of dozen different clients. So we have a page on our intranet. No, I'm not going to show you. Which has all the passwords there. It's just on one page. Now, to get to that page, you have to know our intranet's page. You have to log in with your credentials. You have to two-factor your way through it. I mean, it's only people there can see it. But I can't assign it on a case-by-case basis because it's just basically a web page with all the passwords listed. Well, here you can do that. Really kind of cool, especially even if you don't work for an agency, right? Even if you're just a brand, you probably have a dozen passwords. You've got one for the Twitter account, one for the Instagram account. Hopefully you do not have a Facebook profile with your company name and you share that as the thing you use because Facebook doesn't take kindly to those. But 1Password, that's the number 1 and password, just kind of an interesting thing. I'm just catching up on. Carrie says, Facebook suspended your business Facebook Messenger until January? Why is that happened to you? That is very strange. Let us know in the chat room. That's very peculiar. We'll keep on rolling here. New study coming out now from Forrester. I only pay attention to studies with a high end count. This is what happens when you marry a scientist, right? They show me the data. So this is a high end count. This is an end count of 3,800 people. And they scaled that back to 1,000 of the people who use it regularly. YouTube, Snapchat, Instagram are being used by young people. That's age 12 to 17. Facebook is down there. Now, do not get freaked out when you see these kinds of studies in the media, because here's one way to look at it. Facebook is still 65% of that audience. 65% of regular users of these channels, age 12 to 17, 65% of them use Facebook. That is only a 15% difference from the top. And in fact, when you drill down into it, right, this is what basically the wording around it, more than 60%. Use Facebook the most of all social networks, with 1/3 saying they are on it all the time. So be careful with this one. Sometimes it's very, very different. Hey, here's something that Facebook snuck in here. Maybe it's been there before, but I haven't seen it before. If you want people to buy something online, like if you want them to actually buy, you put an ad campaign out or a promotion that obviously a tradable bits platform or something like that would help with. But are you targeting people who are willing to spend money on Facebook? Well, now Facebook has a behavior you can target in the Facebook ad manager. And it is people who have done some sort of financial transaction on Facebook. So that could be donated. That could be purchased something. It could be that they just have a credit card registered. And then you can also say, I want people who not just have a payment system set up, but who have recently used that payment system. Very, very cool. I'm a big fan and believer of Flux. Flux is a great piece of software. And all it does is it changes the color of your screen. Now, there is some science behind this. Here's the very quick and dirty the science behind it. Blue light when blue light is beamed into your eyes, and blue light is the color that you're getting from TV screens, from your computer monitors, and from your iPhones and so on. It looks white to us, but it's actually in the blue spectrum. When blue light is beamed into your eyes, it suppresses the natural production of serotonin. Trust me, I do not take everything I read on the internet for granted. This is well researched. Blue light beamed into your eyes suppresses the production of melatonin. Melatonin helps you sleep. This is why, by the way, you hear everyone say, don't watch TV an hour before you go to bed and don't read on your iPad before you go to bed. It has nothing to do with the act of watching TV. It has everything to do with the fact that it is light, in particular that white blue color light being beamed into your eyeballs. Now, there are ways around it. If you want to watch TV, I actually have these bright orange glasses. They're orange tinted glasses that I wear. And it helps me sleep because I don't get that blue light. It blocks it out. Flux is really cool because here's what it does. Now, everyone lean into your monitors for a minute here. You're actually looking at our ticketing system for a team member here. But lean in there, and I'm gonna show you what it does to the screen. Everyone ready? Here's what happens to the screen at sunset. One, two, three. Okay, did everyone see that? I'm gonna do it again. Here we go. One, two, three. It's very subtle, right? It's very subtle. And you can change it so you can make it even more intense. What it does is it puts a little bit of an orange hue on it. That's really cool. And now some genius guy has invented this box that will actually plug into the TV screen, to plug into your TV. And it'll at nighttime turn it. What does this have to do with digital marketing? Absolutely nothing. I just thought it was cool. Let's get back to digital marketing now. Yeah, it is a little blurry. Sorry about that. I probably should have made it a bit more interesting. A lot of people ask me, and then we're going to get to the tradable bits demo, and we're going to get to the to this very important animated. I put a lot of work into this animated system or walkthrough of the Facebook Pixel. But a lot of people ask me, where do I find all of these really cool tools? I use a great site called Product Hunt, and there is actually a Chrome extension. And if you Google Chrome extension Product Hunt, every time you open up a new tab in Chrome, it will show you that day's coolest new things. So today, December 4th, this is what popped up for me. There's an icons pack. There's a simple way to design an API. There's a company that curates products and gifts from the internet. This is a well-curated system as well, which is really kind of neat. All right, let's get on to the Tradable Bits demo. Tradable Bits is the platform that we use at EngageQ. We use it with a number of our clients, with the Grey Cup, with Internaturals, with Woodgrove Center, with a whole bunch of things. They are a Vancouver-based company as well. And they have got just a great engagement guide on campaigns, and I'm going to put up a little thing here in the box, and hopefully this works. You now should see in the chat room there an orange button that says download now. If you click that link, you're going to get to a Dropbox site, and just click that download in the download link or direct download in the top. Clicking the download will not remove you from the chat. It'll just open up a new window. So hopefully you're still with us. This is a really cool system that kind of goes through a cool document that goes through everything on their platform with some examples in it. And one of the ones that I want to show you is this exclusive deal. This is just one of about, I don't know, 25, 30 apps that they've got. So here's how this works. You may, in fact, work for a company where you're promoting your business online, but you want to get people through a physical door to buy. You know, let's say you sell paint. You're a paint store. You know, it's all very nice to put up a promotion saying, come to our paint store, and you might get increased traffic, but how do you know that the bricks and mortar got that? Well, you can actually do that through Tradable Bits' exclusive deal, because what it does is it puts a unique code on every activation, essentially, of this claim. So I did a little test run of it. It took me, you know, this thing, it says setup time is 30 minutes. I don't know, Emily, where you're getting that from, because it took me like 10 minutes max to do this. Now, mind you, the graphics are not very great, as you can see. You know, I didn't frame it very well and things. So I just did a little quick 10% off my cat. Obviously, you can make it look a lot nicer. But this is what happens on the user's end, right? And it works on mobile as well. It's fully responsive. They click claim this coupon. You collect whatever information you want. It's CASEL compliant, so they've got to tick off that little allow me to be contacted by email. And then they get this. Now, look at the very bottom of that thing, right? And then they can print it off or take a screenshot of it, you know, and show it to the bricks and mortar store. But two things there, right? The code, I put that in so we can track of the campaigns. You have multiple campaigns running at the same time to test different offers at the store level. And then an ID, that ID is different for every single person who claims it. And then at the store level, you just go to this, to the back end, right? Once you've got the promotion done and you say, I mean, let's say that you set the promotion to say, you know, here's a coupon. And as of January 1st, you can redeem it. So you run that campaign from today until December 31st. So everyone's gathering them and they can start redeeming it after the promotion giveaway stops, right? So you stop doing it. So then you've got this list that you can export. Obviously you'll have a lot more that shows you the ID number of everyone. So you export that list, you print it out, you put it by the cash register or wherever. And when someone comes in and shows you the piece of paper with their unique ID on it or a screenshot, or they just pull it up on their phone, it all works like that. The ID number is right there. You just physically draw a line through them. Thanks. Or put a checkmark box by it. You could use this any number of ways. You could use this for voting, I suppose. You know, I wouldn't want to vote for anything really, really important, but, you know, then you can cross off whether or not people have actually voted as well. So exclusive deal, really cool system. And Tradable Bits is offering for people who watch this, whether you're on the replay or you're watching on YouTube or you're live here with us, and bless your hearts for coming, Brianna, Carrie, Richard, Michael, Pierre, Olivier, Lori, Mark, Emily, Richard, Kim, another Emily, Shefali, Cameron, Linda, excuse me. We usually have like 100 people in here. We have 14 because I screwed it up. But I love you all. I really do. Anyway, so tradablebits.com. And if you use the code ENGAGEQ, they will give you 10% off. Okay, here is the best part of today's episode because I put a lot of work into it. It is a video walkthrough of the Facebook Pixel. Animated. It's not very good. You know, my animation skills are not very good, but it's a good walkthrough. So for those of you who are watching on YouTube or listening on the podcast, you're going to hear 8.5 minutes of silence now because it doesn't do the video injection. If you want to stick around or fast forward to 8.5 minutes from now, you will hear our question and answer period. We'd love to work with you as well. My company is called EngageQ.com. If you book conferences, I'm happy to chat with you about coming and presenting all of this stuff. Just go to toddmaffin.com/presentations. And now start your engines. Let's hopefully this will work. Here is 8.5 minutes of the Facebook Pixel. And I will be back to answer your questions about the Facebook Pixel or anything we covered after we go. All right, so there it is. Hopefully that worked. And hopefully it was helpful. I don't do too many of those videos, but I find it sometimes helpful to have a walkthrough. I have put a poll up in the chat room, whether you're watching on the replay or whether you are here live with us. Just check the tabs there under the poll. It'd be interesting to know how many of you use the Facebook Pixel, how many of you do not use the Facebook Pixel. And that's it. And one more time, do make sure that you download this offer, which is free. It is a great resource from Tradable Bits. It walks you through all of their various systems. So that's it. Happy to answer any questions in the channel. Please type away, or there's a tweet or share button down below, which you're welcome to use as well. And I will wait. I will wait. Of course, Emily, you use the Facebook Pixel. There's a bit of a delay for before I get to see your questions, and if there aren't any after about 30 seconds, then we usually call it a day. And I'm trying to take Friday afternoons off, by the way. This is my new work-life balance method. I can't this week because we worked the Grey Cup last week and Black Friday last week, so I've got a couple of people, excuse me, on holidays, so I'm kind of doing double duty on the client channels. But usually I just play video games Friday afternoon. Is that wrong? I don't know. Maybe that's wrong. any questions, please feel free to use it. I'm going to close the poll in about 15 seconds, so make sure that you vote in the poll there. Thanks, Emily. Have a great weekend yourself. Can you do multiple conversions? You absolutely can. Why don't we do a quick walkthrough right now, in fact, while you're here, so you can see sort of how the multiple conversion things work. So I'm just going to open up. I know you can't see right now. I just got to get through some passwording stuff. And we're going to go here, and we're going to go here. All right. I will drag this window up, and I will expand it, and I will blow it up so you can see it. All right. This is just my personal account so that we're not sharing all sorts of stuff here. So this is how you do it, essentially. So you've got under tools, you've got pixels. That's where you can see the pixels. Oh, you know what? No. I can't show it to you. I can't show it to you because it does have some confidential stuff in it. However, you can, and the way to do it is actually fairly easy. If you go through where I created that one pixel that talked about the creating the unique one. I forget it because I wasn't able to hear the video. I was only able to see it go through there. But when you created the, you know, they viewed this content or they purchased it, you can create up to 20. You can rename them. Right now you can't delete them. So you're only limited to 20, which is a bit strange. But you can, you absolutely can. And you know, if you just Google multiple conversions, actually, you know what? There's a great resource that John Loomer has. John Loomer is a very smart guy. If you go to his site, johnloomer.com, and you do pixel conversion, I'm guessing would be a good search term to use. Let's see if we can find something in there. That's not it. Here we go. Custom conversions, a beginner's guide. So johnloomer.com. It's really very cool. And so let's go through here. And so this is how you do it. Let's zoom into that image. So just like before, how you could see what the URL contains. If you want to do one for people who landed on the checkout page, then you can put that URL in there. You can also create an event so you can have it fire specifically. The short answer is yes, you can. That's a few of what his look like. So good resource to have, johnloomer.com, if you want to check that out. He actually has a thing called the Power Hitters Club, which is his sort of annual subscription to an annual subscription that he has to the a weekly webinar he does and some videos that he does. It's expensive. It's about $1,000 US a year. But I do find it worthwhile. So that's it. Let's see what the poll results have been for that one. Wow, a lot. Not many of you have even heard of it. Some of you do use it. So good to see. So again, my apologies, everyone, for the just the last week's screw up. You know, it sent out that I did send an email out prior saying that there's a pre-recorded episode about Ad Espresso because I wasn't able to do it live. But my email wasn't very clear. And then the stupid platform sent out a replay link automatically. So that was a problem. And then this week, I created a 15-minute warning and forgot to put the link in. So I'm guessing a lot of you are watching this on the replay. So thank you, and my apologies, and it will not happen again. One question here from Linda is the Facebook help content that tells you to put values in the pixel code old instructions. They mostly are old instructions. So what you're talking about there, Facebook used to have a different way of doing the pixels. It used to be that for every conversion you wanted to track, you'd have a different pixel. So you would put a specific pixel on a page for people who viewed a blog post, or and then a different pixel on a page for people who got to the thank you for subscribing to our newsletter, a different pixel for people who made a purchase. And it was kind of a pain to track them all. So you replace it now with this one Facebook pixel, and you no longer have to edit the code with the conversion value, because you don't edit the code. You just put that one pixel on your website and it's there forever. And then when you're creating the conversion pixels, really what you're doing on the Facebook side is you're not making a new pixel when you're creating a custom conversion, you're creating a marker in the report. So you're saying anytime, you know, and so let's imagine that the Facebook pixel, which is firing on every page, remember now, the new pixel is on every single page, but you say in my reports, if it fires on a page that says thank you for subscribing in the URL, well, that one has a conversion value of zero because it's just an email list, but I want to see that in the reports. But if you are selling something that's $10, when you create that custom conversion, you can give it that conversion value and say, you know, that's worth $10. Now, if you have variable conversion values, here's a good case in point, the Vancouver Sun Run, which is a client of ours, they have a conversion pixel on theirs. Well, they just call it the Facebook pixel now, because it does website custom audiences and conversions. They've got a number of different price points, right? They've got a price point for team registrations, one for individual registration, one for youth, one for early bird. The only way to track that is actually to get into the code and to tell the database, the e-commerce database engine, to spit at the code, to spit out the value. So that does require a little bit of custom work on the web development end if you're selling products with multiple values. So that's it. I think that's it. We'll be back to normal, and hopefully I won't screw it up next week. Thank you for again if you're watching on the replay. One last time here. Oh, it's already up there. Click that orange download now button under the offers tab for that tradable bits resource. It's very helpful. And now I am off to go back to work, and then at 3:00 I'm shutting it down. Because I have Fallout 4 to play. Thanks again for watching. See you in a week. Bye, everyone.